friends, I'm Mosmi Ambasta, and today we are going to talk about a very important concept called cut order plan or cut plan. This is used in every garment manufacturing facility. What is cut order plan? Basically, it is deciding a combination of markers and lays to plan your entire order. This decision has a huge impact on the factory savings. The objective of making a good cut plan is basically to reduce your overall costs. The major costs in the cutting room are fabric cost, marker making cost, spreading cost, cutting cost, and bundling cost. Let us understand these costs one by one. Fabric is the biggest chunk of the cost. 50 to 70% of the garment cost goes in the fabric. Labor is 10 to 15% of the cost, and cutting room labor cost is much more smaller. Therefore, fabric is the major influencer on cut order planning process, and we should always try to minimize it. The second cost is the marker making cost. With the advent of CAD systems, we've moved from manual marker making to automated marker making. This has made the process much more cost efficient and faster. The impact of marker making cost on cut order plan is much smaller. The next cost we are going to talk about is spreading cost. There are three parameters that majorly affect spreading cost. The first one is total fabric being laid. Every meter that we add adds to the cost of the laying team or the spreading machine being used. So the lesser the number of meters of fabric we are laying, the lesser the first parameter of spreading cost, which is total fabric being laid. The second parameter is number of lays. Every new lay that we add to the cut plan adds to the lay preparation cost. There's a cost of preparing the table, putting the paper on top, markings on the table, which adds to a major cost. The lesser the number of lays, the lesser the overall spreading cost. The third parameter is number of roll changes. Every new roll adds to the handling of the roll cost. So you would remove the previous roll and put the next roll on top. We understand that if we minimize all the three parameters, we will be able to minimize overall spreading cost. Similarly, also that if we have minimized the overall fabric being used in the cut plan, we can minimize the spreading cost. The fourth major cost that we need to talk about is cutting cost. Cutting cost is directly dependent on the number of bodies being cut in the order. If a cut plan ensures that the number of bodies being cut in the order are minimal, we can control cutting costs. The last cost we need to talk about is the bundling cost. Bundling cost depends on order quantity, size of bundles, and number of parts. Cut order planning does not have a major impact on bundling cost. However, a good cut plan can majorly ease the process of bundling in the cutting room. Looking at these five costs, we understand that fabric has a very big impact on the cut order planning, and it should be the first priority. So how do we reduce our fabric cost and maximize fabric utilization by making a good cut order plan? Well, we'll discuss that in the next video. Stay tuned. If this video was useful to you, please like, share, and subscribe for more such videos coming up on Stitch Diary. Thank you. Today I'm going to talk about the characteristics of a good cut order plan.